Yes or no? Can you give me an example of a motion which is not in a straight line? Of course, circle motion is one such. Tell me a routine, I mean the pendulum. Pendulum is said. Pendulum motion is not a straight line? Rotatory motion. Sit down. What else? Projectile motion. What else? Ajay, tell me one thing. If I throw an object up, it move in a straight line or not completely? If I throw an object down, it move in a straight line. If I just drop it, it again moves in a straight line. Right? But if I throw an object like this, will it go in a straight line? No. It will follow a curve like this. Yes or no? It won't. Right? If I throw it at some angle, then also it will not go in a straight line. Okay? So these kind of motion are very common. Okay, it's like, you know, suppose you are bombing your enemy, you're in a fighter plane, and you drop a bomb, your bomb follow a projectile path. It doesn't fall vertically down like this. Okay? So we'll learn about projectile motion later on, class 11, not now. But there is another kind of power motion which is very popular, or very common, which is circular motion. You can see here also, fan is having circular motion, yes or no? No. Fan is not a particle, first of all. Okay? But if you say that fan is made up of multiple particles, all the particles are moving in a circular motion? Yes or no? You tie an object with a string and you rotate, it moves in a circular motion? Yes or no? So, circular motion. And again, you can see the vehicles moving on the road. The circular motion is very, very, very common. Alright? So, in our class 9 syllabus, we have circular motion. Okay? Which we have to study. Now, circular motion will have two types. One will be uniform circular motion. Please write down. This is uniform circular motion and this is non-uniform circular motion. What do you think will be the difference? I mean, this is all the circular motion, this is all the circular motion. Both are moving in the same radius, let's say radius r. Okay, what would be the difference?
Speed.
Okay, here the speed is constant while it is moving in a circular motion. Here the speed is changing. Getting it? So in our syllabus we have uniform circular motion. This will come in 11th. Okay? So we have a circular motion in which the particle is moving with uniform speed. Any doubt? Okay? So let us start discussion on uniform circular motion. Alright? But before we even start uniform circular motion, can you define what is circular motion itself? I mean, we know what is, you can give examples like this is a circular motion, that is a circular motion. But what is the definition of circular motion? When it happens? Circular path motion is a circular motion. You are defining circular motion using circular motion itself. That is not happening. Anybody else? What is a circular motion? About a fish? About a point? A particle moves about a point. Distance of that point to the particle is fixed. Fine? When a particle is moving so that, write down. When a particle is moving, so that the distance of the particle from a fixed point, distance of the particle from a fixed point is constant. okay, then it performs several motion, isn't it? Like this, right? Now I'm going to ask you a question here. Suppose the tip of the fan is a particle, okay, tip of the fan is a small particle. Is that particle moving a circular path? Yes. Or where is the fixed point? Center. Okay. Now, center is at rest? Center is at rest with respect to earth. Okay. Now, why I am asking you a question like this? Suppose, I don't know whether you understand this. See, I want to say that with respect to center, the edge of this thing follow a circle. Okay. Now the center is center moving in a circle with respect to edge.
No, not.
Is center moving? Achha, first tell me that. Is the edge moving relative to the center? Yes. All of you agree? Now tell me, is the center moving relative to edge?
Yes.
You might have experienced when two trains are standing. You are in a train, I told you, right? This thing, that your train is at rest, but when you look at the other train, with respect to other train, you seem to be moving, but you are at rest. Okay, so the center is at rest, understood, but it is moving with respect to edge or not? It is moving with respect to edge. Are you getting it? Now its distance from the edge is fixed or not? It is fixed. Okay, so even the center is moving in a circle with respect to edge. Very difficult to visualize, but it is true. But this is not in our syllabus. In our syllabus, the fixed point is always at rest. But just that I am telling you that the fixed point need not be at rest. Huh.
Sir, if the body is moving above the main point, is it called rest?
Body is moving?
At the point. It's moving.
How do you understand?
If the body is moving at one point itself,
even the top is such examples. Okay, we, our focus is just one point moving in a circle. So there is no confusion. Getting it? But when you take an example of fan, all the points are moving in a circle with different speeds. Getting it? Okay. Any other doubt? Any other doubt? Okay, now draw a circle like this. Draw a circle. Radius is R. Radius is R. Okay. Now, if uniform speed is U, if U is a uniform speed, you have to tell me how much time it will take to complete one revolution. To complete one revolution, how much time it will take? How much time it will take to complete one revolution? Anybody has brought our science book? Is there an acceleration? Think about it and tell me. Acceleration is zero or not? How many of you say acceleration is zero? You don't have any opinion? Zero. Zero. Acceleration is zero? Okay. Put your hands down. The answer is, it is not zero. What is acceleration? Velocity changing? Is velocity constant? How many say velocity is constant here? Velocity has magnitude as well as direction. Suppose the object is rotating like this, right now its velocity is like this, then it goes like this. Is the velocity changed or same?
Changing. Yes, so in the direction, the speed
will change,
the magnitude
will change. Speed doesn't change, but acceleration is not rate of change of speed. Acceleration is rate of change of velocity. So acceleration is there. I'll tell you one more example is like this. Suppose that a ball is going like this. Okay, a ball is traveling like that. If you have to make sure that ball turns with the same velocity here, you need to apply a force or not? You need to apply a force. You need to kick it. The velocity the speed is unchanged, but direction is changed. So you are applying force. If you are applying force, there is an acceleration. Acceleration will be there even if there is change in direction. Getting it? Okay. Now if acceleration is there, you need force or not to create acceleration? Yes or no? Write down if acceleration. You know that force equal to mass and acceleration? You know this or not? You know this? It's a basic relation. Force equals to mass time acceleration. I am saying acceleration is there. So force also should be there. If acceleration is zero, then force is zero. Getting it? Write down. Write down. An object moving with uniform circular motion. An object moving uniform circular motion will have an acceleration. Will have an acceleration.
More the round, the faster it
will. More? No, I'm coming to that. First,